Blackstone Publishing and Skyboat Media present The Apple Tree Throne by Premee Mohamed. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. For the Unloved and the Loved. It's autumn, the time for ghost stories. Not the innocent skies and washed-out roads of spring, not the stifling heat of summer, nor less the dead of winter when sound carries for miles. Autumn is when adventures begin, when the air is crisp and the paths are dry and the leaves whisper and the scent of smoke on the downs travels like a secret. It must be autumn, when everyone is held in abeyance between their home and their destination, when every trip is a journey. I wake to tapping at the glass, and spend a moment reckoning it. Dash, 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 dot. Dash, 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 dot. Two nines. Get out. Shot. I roll out of bed and see the Major General, still quite dead. As dead as the last time I saw him, hovering above the sill. The new electric streetlights, soft and golden in the fog, illuminate the gaping wound in his throat. Meeting my gaze with a look of hatred, he reaches out once more and strikes the glass of the window. 9-9. I pull the curtains shut, muffling his outrage till I can drop off again. Perhaps he is still angry about the funeral. Major General Theodore Wickersley was a good man, I begin. But this statement is so contradictory to what is actually transpiring at his funeral that I trail off in embarrassment. In the silence, Wickersley's mother emits one loud sob, sending crows yelping from the fawn sea of oaks behind us. Surely for her sake, if for nothing else, I must continue. Before I lose my nerve, I describe his rapid rise through the ranks, his fairness as a leader, his loyalty as a soldier. I praise his brilliant military mind, stuttering into silence as another of Wickersley's irregulars gestures frantically at me to cut it out. I express my deep condolences to the Greater Republic of Britannia, as well as his family, friends, and fellow soldiers. As I do so, several of my fellow soldiers simply leave, slipping past the rows of family with murmured excuses, as if a quiet slap to the face might be any less painful than a loud one. I am the only one who has agreed to speak. It is over swiftly, and the spade man walks bold as brass through the assembled mourners, who part Red Sea fashion to avoid his dirty shovel. He nods briskly at me, as one professional to another, and begins to fill in the grave. Wickersley's mother handed me a pink rose when I met them at the gates, which I had meant to toss upon the coffin, but the work is proceeding so swiftly that I feel it would be an intrusion. In minutes it is done, and he switches to another tool with a flat, oblong head to tamp down the fluffed-up black dirt. Finally, the sliced squares of sod are replaced. They will catch again, put down roots long before winter comes. Funny that cemeteries always end up on the best farmland. Or is it the other way around? All those bodies turning the thin soil rich and black over hundreds of years. That old story they tell to scare children about what happens to those who eat hazelnuts from a cemetery. Wickersley's father touches the spade man's elbow, and coins discreetly chime between them. The forelock tugged, tools gathered, the small man melts into the serried graves. We few remain, and the sun begins to burn off the fog, and heat seeps into our grateful backs. From the small hillock upon which eulogizers traditionally stand, I look down at the bereft family, and see replicated in its various forms the face of the man who almost killed me. The black hair, the pearly eyes, like high, far-off clouds. The top brass wouldn't permit a burial at Mossley, of course. Days ticked by while the family petitioned them, and finally the reply came. Take the body and go, but he cannot go where the others went, and not one shilling will we pay. And so here we are today at St. Thomas.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.